It was the second last sitting day of the year and it delivered the government an early Christmas present, the Prime Minister managing to rid himself of the Medevac bill. The law has haunted Scott Morrison since it passed in February, supposedly weakening his borders, but more importantly, his power.
Here we go.
In the true spirit of Christmas, Parliament is a place of give and take.
Maybe it should apply to question time.
In the Senate, it was Jackie Lambie who handed the Prime Minister his gift.
I am voting for the repeal of Medevac.
Laws that bring Sikh refugees from offshore detention to Australia for medical treatment, now scrapped.
To shut the door that Labor sought to prize open last year.
The key vote that killed Medevac was independent Jackie Lambie, who cut a deal with the government she won't reveal.
When I say I can't discuss it publicly due to national security concerns, I am being 100% honest to you.
There is no secret deal.
Who's lying? Who's lying, Minister Coleman?
And no further clarity on an offer from New Zealand willing to settle asylum seekers from Papua New Guinea and Nauru.
The only undertaking we have given is to implement our policies.
184 people have been transferred to Australia via Medevac since the law passed in February with the help of Labor, the Greens and Independents. But nobody has gone back. Some have been accused of using creative ways to exploit the law.
Self-inflicted, like palm oil into their bloody penises.
Scott Morrison saw Medevac as a personal affront, that laws he didn't support passed a parliament he was supposed to be in control of, and that's why the Prime Minister was determined to see them scrapped. But how he proposes to get the almost 600 people in detention out is still a secret. Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.